Hey Love, this is Jay, and I'm back with a midweek message for you. And this is going to be from March 8th through March 14th. This is going to be three messages for you. You can choose message one, two, or three. You can pause this video for a second and meditate on it for a second and choose your number. Choose the first number that comes to you. Don't think twice about it, okay? So you can pause this video now and we'll get started. Click back on when you're ready, and we'll jump right into message one. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Comment below if this resonates with you. I hope you all are doing well. You guys have had a beautiful full moon in Virgo, and if you have yet to check out your zodiac reading, make sure you head on over to my channel now to check that out. Let's get a message from the universe for our first message here. Let's see, what message does the universe have for us? All right, the forgive card is message one. Of course, anger can always be justified, but then so can forgiveness. Just depends on how much more you want from the adventure, okay? So the forgive card is coming out for you for message one. Let's pull some more oracles to see what your angels and guides have to say. And we can sort of get a little storyline here for you. Messages for the collective. We have relationships, so maybe some of you are needing to forgive someone. Someone that you may have been in a relationship with intimately, or maybe a family member, a friend, a parent. This says your primary relationship is with yourself and God, and every other relationship follows from there. To attract, heal, or balance a relationship, then snuggle more closely with your loving creator. As you feel safe in love within, so shall your other relationships bloom and prosper. Okay, so we have those two messages, and we're going to pull one more oracle for you. Okay, we have romance angels are helping you. So you guys need some love right now, message one. My message one people, romance angels are helping you right now. So maybe some of you have been in have been going through a hard time. This card says, dear guardian angels of my soulmate, thank you for preparing my soulmate and me for love, for giving us the motivation to make helpful life changes, and for arranging for us to meet. Thank you for helping us recognize each other and have the courage to say hello so that we can eventually delve into a truly intimate relationship. Okay, so we have the forgive, the relationship card, as well as the romance card here. And let's pull some tarot around this. See what's coming out for you. Cards and one from the bottom. All right. So we have the Six of Wands, the Seven of Swords here, and then the Nine of Wands. So Wands, some of you are definitely either in your thoughts, emotional about something, possibly forgiving someone, or is an issue or situation in a relationship that your guides and angels are trying to assist you with right now. So this Six of Wands energy here, I do feel like you'll be victorious in whatever this situation may be. Whatever this, whatever has come up in your life that you may be struggling with right now that you need to forgive, there will be victory on the other side. You will make it to the other side. I know for some of you, it feels like it's a long way, that it's a long journey from now until then, but it does feel like you will definitely get to the win. Okay, and I do feel like you will be rewarded for it in a way, what I feel is there may have been a misunderstanding in a relationship for some of you, and someone has to just sort of take the initiative to either apologize, either clear the air or something like that. That's what's coming up when it comes to a relationship dynamic. So if you're needing to apologize to someone, this could be a good week to begin to open up the space so that you can forgive yourself, the person, and the situation at hand. The Seven of Swords energy here, so I feel like some of you may have felt like you have been manipulated in a way, or someone was trying to get away with something, or there's been some sort of like backstabbing or something, some sort of gossip or something that may have been going on. But I feel like it has taken you out of your character in a way. So this situation does need to be forgiven, okay? The Nine of Wands energy here, this is definitely, again, pointing to an energy of like you being exhausted and tired, like you're battling someone, like you've been at war with someone, or you've been at war with a situation. Some of you have just been at war with your own thoughts, is what Spirit is saying. So it does feel like that you will overcome this. This is a good week to really start opening up the door, opening yourself up to the forgiveness process and letting go of things, because there is a lot on the other side for you, okay? It's just a matter of you're needing to get there. And that Six of Wands is definitely pointing to you will have success in this situation of forgiveness, or, you know, maybe winning back a partner, or saving a friendship or saving a relationship in some sort of way, okay? So let's move into message two. Let's see what the universe has to say. What message? We have this one. Do something new, something different. Ever notice how it's easier to fall in love and be falling in love with, even when you're busy, even when life throws curveballs at you, or life feels like it's not working in your favor? There is something new that's on the horizon for you. You have to do something different, okay? But you see how the new is highlighted? There is something new on the horizon for some of you when it comes to those that have chosen message two. Now let's see what else we, our guides and angels, have to say for message two. We have the Ask card. So whatever it is that you have been wanting to bring into your life, what the newness that you're seeking, all you have to do is ask for it through prayer and meditation, and your angels and guides will be right there to help you. Ask us to help you in this situation, and we will immediately go to work on your behalf. We're governed by many universal loves, and sorry, I thought I could read that. My eyes are like, huh? Girl, get it together. And among them is the free will that allows you to make your own choices and decisions. So we patiently await your request, okay, the ask. And also this card is connected to the throat chakra, also the third eye as well, that indigo color, but definitely the throat of asking. Ask, believe, you shall receive. I always say ask, believe. As believe and know, as believe, receive and know. So definitely know that whatever it is that you ask for, that you ask the universe for, you're going to get it. It's kind of like putting in an Amazon order. It's sort of an analogy that I use here and there. When you order something from Amazon, you place the order, you have a tracking number, and you know that it's on its way. It's very similar with the blessing, or what, when you ask for something. Granted, you don't have a tracking number, but you asked for it, you paid for it, you know that it's going to show up, you're just waiting for it to come. But you go on about your life as if, you know, you go on about your daily routine, and knowing that that package, that blessing, is going to show up. So that is what Spirit is saying to you. Do something new, something different, and ask for assistance. So even if you guys, some of you are not, do not have like a daily practice as far as like meditation, journaling, or praying, maybe it's something new for you to take on so that your blessings can come to fruition. Okay, let's see, get one more message for you. actually going to take this up, that one wanted to fall out. Positive thoughts create positive results. Positive thoughts creates positive results. So remember I say ask, believe, receive. Once you put in that order, know that it is on its way to you. So don't doubt. You don't doubt your Amazon order is if it's going to show up or not. You know that it's coming. And it's the same with your blessing here. This one says divine love and wisdom. I call upon you now. I know that my mind and emotions are eternally and continuously connected to you. I ask my higher self to be aware and conscious of the love and light that is within every person and situation. Okay, so let's pull some tarot for you. So we have the do something new, something different, ask, and then positive thoughts create positive results. Messages for a message to please. We have the Seven of Cups. We have the Ace of Pentacles. On the bottom of the deck, I have the Star card, a major arcana here. So we have the Seven of Cups, Ace of Cups. I'm sorry, Seven of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. This energy here for you. Okay. So with that Seven of Cups things, this is what the Seven of Cups message, Spirit is saying that there are opportunities. I feel like some of you are in a place of creating this negative illusion that things will not work out in your favor, and Spirit is saying that it will. You actually have opportunities. I feel like those opportunities have not come to the forefront as of yet because you're still in a negative mind frame. You're still in this place of continuously creating patterns that, or creating thoughts that create patterns of scarcity, lack, and limitation. Okay, so that's what that feels like. But that Seven of Cups is saying that there are multiple possibilities. There are opportunities that are on the board for you. You basically have to get out of your own way and get out of your own head. Okay, you have to dive down into your heart space. And this is why Spirit is saying ask, doing something different, asking for something new. How can you change your verbiage? How can you change your thought process? Because some of you have had the same thought process for, I mean, your whole life. And if things are not working out for you, that means your way isn't working. So let's find a different way to manifest in your life, okay? So you can ask that. You can ask for help from people in general, family, friends, or you ask Spirit for help. You don't have to know how. You just have to take the first step, right? So the Ace of Pentacles, there is opportunities for money to come in. So if some of you have been struggling in that area, the financial sector, there is an opportunity or a financial opportunity that may come in for you as well. I do also feel like some of you could be in a place of investing if you are already in this place of having the luxury of having monetary abundance, that you could be making investments. I'm picking up some of you may be thinking about buying a home or actually purchasing a home within the next week, or this could be down the road. But I feel like there is an investment that is going to be made for some of you. But this card is about manifestations here. I do feel like a new door is opening for you only when you change the way that you're thinking. Okay, so if you chose message two, that is very important. Positive thoughts create positive results. Okay. And then we have the Star energy here. And this is about you creating happiness in your life, because maybe some of you were in this dark place, this sort of delusional place with the Seven of Cups right here, feeling like you're out of choices, you're overwhelmed. But the Star energy comes in and say there's a lot of healing. There's a lot of balance for you, a lot of serenity. A lot of good luck is on your side. So if some of you are, again, like I said, wanting financial abundance, there is an opportunity for that. You just literally have to get out of your own way. Seriously. Okay, so ask for help in whatever capacity that you need that assistance in order to receive your blessings, because your blessings are sitting right there. They're sitting right there. They're just waiting for you to open up to them. Okay. So that Star energy here is saying that success is on the horizon. If you allow yourself to ask, believe, receive, and create positive thoughts in your life. Let's get that last message for you. Message three, and see what is coming up for you guys. All right. Message from the universe for message three. Whoa. All right. So we have You needn't worry. So you need not to worry is what Spirit is saying. There's no one in your life who hasn't always loved you. They're all just learning how to show it. Okay. And maybe that is you in this moment, learning how to love yourself. Okay. So that is a message that you need to not worry right now. Okay. Forever. Got butterfingers today. Let's start that over. Message 3. We have the Innocence card here connected to the crown chakra. Okay, Innocence card. And this card says, beloved one, everyone is guiltless in truth, as no one can alter God's handiwork of perfection. Give us your feelings of heaviness so we can lighten your load. Give us any guilt, anger, or blame that may shroud your loving outlook. Enjoy the peace without your heart once more, within your heart once more. So we have needed not worry. That Innocence is saying that, I feel like this energy is like, you've done nothing wrong. If some of you have been worried or just doubting yourself or just feeling fear and shame and blame, and then this victim state, Spirit is saying, your angels are saying that you've done nothing wrong. Okay, so you need not to worry about anything. Let's pull one more message for you. Two messages wanted to come out. Shield yourself, forgive yourself, you've done nothing wrong. I can't even make this up. This is what your angels what I just channeled for you. You've done nothing wrong. So these are your two messages here. Forgive yourself, you've done nothing wrong, and shield yourself. Okay, so now you're in the place of taking care of you. I'm not going to read both of those cards there, but because you get the gist of it. Forgiving yourself and shielding yourself. That's, I feel like I said, you need to not worry about anything. Some of you are needing to really turn inward and begin to love yourself more. And I feel like this kind of bounces off message too with you. There's nothing for you to worry about. Okay. Let's pull some tarot and see what's going on here. Bottom of the deck, the Eight of Wands. That's the Eight of Wands, the Three of Pentacles. I'll leave this upright, that Eight of Wands. So we have the Nine of Cups here, the Judgment, and then we have the Three of Pentacles energy. Also, that fourth card was the Eight of Wands that wanted to come out there. So if you guys can see that there. So this Nine of Cups is saying that you don't need to worry about anything because your blessings are coming, but there is a level of an energy of you being fulfilled, okay? I really feel strongly that whoever chose this message, you're very, very pure at heart. You're probably very empathic and pick up a lot of things, which is why Spirit is saying to shield yourself. And I do feel like that you have done so much for other people. You feel like you've done a lot for yourself, but there you're in a place of feeling worried and feeling like it is enough, isn't it enough, or isn't enough, or feeling like you will never receive your blessings. But with this Nine of Cups energy here is telling me that there is a lot of fulfillment that is going to happen for you. There is a lot of abundance that is coming into your life. I feel like your cups are filled, okay? Your cups are definitely filled. And I feel like this is some of you are in the place of looking at the glass half full instead of half empty, which is a great place to be in. So transitioning from glass half empty to glass half full in this card of you needing not to worry, I feel like you can ask for assistance from your guides and angels. Forgive yourself yourselves for things that have transpired in your life because you've done nothing wrong. But this is the card about stability and prosperity here. This judgment card is all and making me feel like you guys have gone through a cycle, okay, and maybe gone through many relationships where you have a sense of lack of esteem or lack of confidence, or just this blockage of feeling like you're not enough or worthy of. But Spirit is saying otherwise, okay? The judgment card is a card of you problem solving. So I feel like you're going to get through this situation. There is an awakening that some of you are going through right now, which is why you're transitioning from glass half empty to glass half full. And I do feel with the Three of Pentacles here, you do have the support that you need. So you may have to ask for the support, not expecting anyone to read your mind. But there is a lot that's unfolding for you on a deep cellular level, and you may not understand any of what is transpiring or what is shifting right now in your life. So it is a good idea for you guys to get help, okay? Get help, ask for help. I feel like you guys have been putting in the work, and some of you have been doing it alone, but now is the time to ask for help. You have a team, you have the support behind you, okay? So things are definitely looking up for you, and you're just in a space of growing and collaborating and moving through this cycle right here of this judgment. You're changing your status here. Okay. And I feel like, again, that awakening is so strong, but I feel like you guys are, you're hearing now, you're listening, and things are shifting in a beautiful way. The Eight of Wands here was on the bottom of the deck when I said ask for help. This card is about communication. I don't know if that's going to pop in for you, but the Eight of Wands, that is about communication. And I do feel like this is energy that's going to happen rather quickly when you say yes, or when you ask for the help, things are going to begin to unfold. The clock says 444 right now. So your angels are saying everything that I am validating for you, or everything that I'm saying is validating to you already. You already know this. Okay. So that's a message that could be coming in for you, but this is a sense of freedom in your spirit as well, okay? So that is your reading, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. Be sure to leave me a comment below. Let me know if you chose message one or two, or leave me a heart emoji. I would greatly appreciate that. I will see you guys very soon for your next week midweek reading. And it's my birthday next Wednesday, but I'm still going to bring you guys a message, okay? So again, thanks for tuning in. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. I'll see you guys very, very soon. Many blessings, love, and light, guys. Peace.